Welcome, geometry students. Today we're going to be learning about target 1.4, which is solving right triangles using right triangle trigonometry, sine, cosine, and tangent. All right, so first of all, what is a trig ratio? A trig ratio is a comparison of lengths of two sides in a right triangle. So we are still working with right triangles. Just as a reminder, with a right triangle, all right triangles have one right angle. We have a hypotenuse, which is always the side length across from the right angle, and then our two legs. These ratios, so the trig ratios, will be used to find the measure of a side in a right triangle or the measure of one of the acute angles in a right triangle. So if we look at this particular right triangle, we still have a hypotenuse just like we did when we worked with Pythagorean theorem. But now we're going to be more specific about how we label our legs. With Pythagorean theorem, the legs could be used interchangeably, but with these trig functions, we have to be more particular. So if we reference an acute angle, in this case, I'm going to look at angle A. We're going to reference our legs as either the opposite leg or the adjacent leg. So in reference to this angle, the opposite leg is the leg that doesn't touch that angle. So in this case, that would be segment BC. And then the adjacent leg, when we talk about adjacent, that's going to be the leg that touches the angle. Now, if you're thinking there's two side lengths that touch that angle A, that is true, but one is already the hypotenuse. So we want the adjacent leg, and that would be segment AC in this case. All right, so let's talk about some of our abbreviations that we're going to be seeing. The tangent of angle A can be written as tan angle A. Sine of angle A can be written as sin angle A. And the abbreviation for cosine would be cos of angle A. So those are how we'll abbreviate our ratios and how you'll see it on your calculator as well. So what about tan of angle A? Well, it's a ratio, so it's a comparison of two side lengths. So the tan is equal to the opposite leg over the adjacent leg. The sine is the opposite leg over the hypotenuse. And finally, the cosine is the adjacent leg over the hypotenuse. So if you look at these three ratios, they're all referencing either the opposite leg, the hypotenuse, or the adjacent leg, and they're all a little bit different. So the way you can remember these is SOHCAHTOA. SOHCAHTOA, you might be wondering, what does it have to do with geometry? But it's just a little way to remember which trig function uses which of the side lengths. So SO stands for sine, and if you look at the sine, O over H stands for opposite over hypotenuse. So ca is our cosine. So here's our cosine of the angle, and that's equal to adjacent over hypotenuse. So C is equal to A over H. There's our ca. And finally, TOA, T standing for tan, is opposite over adjacent. So O over A. So anytime you're trying to remember which ratio to use, you can just remind yourself of SOHCAHTOA. All right, example one says to find tan of angle S, cosine of angle S, and sine of angle S. Write each answer as both a fraction and as a decimal rounded to four places. So looking at this, we're not actually finding an unknown side length since we know all three of the side lengths in this right triangle. What we're doing instead is we're just practicing setting up the ratios. So let's start with tan. So if you forget one of the ratios, just remind yourself of SOHCAHTOA. Okay, so tan of an angle, in this case angle S, Keep in mind this is always an acute angle, so we would never find, for example, in this case, tan of angle T, since that's the right angle. So we're always going to be working with an acute angle here. So tan is the TOA, so O over A, or opposite over adjacent. All right, well, here's our angle that we're talking about. If you notice, we have two different acute angles. So if this had been angle R, our ratio would be different. So opposite, well, the leg opposite, not touching the angle S, is 80. And the leg adjacent, keep in mind, we have two lengths adjacent or touching that angle, but only one is a leg. So we're going to use 18 in this case. 82 would have been the hypotenuse. So we want to simplify our ratio. We have a ratio of 40:9, and that's approximately 4.4444. Let's repeat that for the cosine of angle S. So the cosine, or the ka part of our SOHCAHTOA, is A over H, which stands for adjacent over hypotenuse. So still referencing the acute angle S, so adjacent to that would be 18, and in this case the hypotenuse is 82. So our ratio is 18 over 82, which simplifies to be 9 compared to 41, or approximately 0.2195. And finally, we're going to do the same thing for sine of angle S. So sine is the SO part of SOHCAHTOA, opposite over hypotenuse. And opposite of angle S, once again, is 80, and the hypotenuse is 82. So we're comparing 80 to 82, which reduces to be 40/41, or approximately 0.9756. So we're just looking at how these different side lengths compare to one another here. Let's see how we can use SOHCAHTOA or our trig functions to find an unknown side length in a right triangle. So it's example two. You want to string cable to make a dog run from two corners of a building as shown in the diagram. Write and solve a proportion using a trigonometric ratio to approximate the length of cable you will need. So I want to find this length x. It's telling us that it's going to make a triangle, specifically a right triangle, in this little inlet of the building. So I know a couple of things about this triangle. I know that we have an acute angle. I already mentioned that we have a right angle, so that makes it a right triangle. And we have a side length of 11 feet. Now, normally, we would just use Pythagorean theorem to find the unknown side length. However, we don't have enough information because we don't have two of the three sides. However, this acute angle is going to make it possible for us to use a trig ratio. So if we look at our SOHCAHTOA, we have to choose which trig ratio to use. Here's how we're going to decide that. We're going to look at our known information. Well, in reference to our acute angle, we know the opposite side length, specifically the opposite leg. Then we want to think about what we're trying to find. Well, we're trying to find the hypotenuse. So we have to think opposite and hypotenuse. Which one of our trig functions deals with the opposite and hypotenuse? And that happens to be the sine function. So sine of the angle is equal to opposite, meaning the opposite leg, over the hypotenuse. So now specifically the acute angle is 35 degrees. So we're going to put that amount in. The opposite leg is 11 and the hypotenuse is x. In my opinion, the easiest way to work this problem from here is just to make it into a proportion by making both sides into a fraction. So I'm going to put sine of 35 over 1. Now I'm going to cross multiply. In other words, I'm going to multiply what's diagonal from x with that quantity. So x times sine of 35. And then I set that equal to the product of my other diagonal. So 11 times 1, which is 11. Now my goal is to find x, so I'm going to solve this by dividing by sine of 35, and whatever I do to keep my balanced equation, whatever I do to one side, I need to do to the other. So sine of 35 is going to cancel with sine of 35, leaving me that x equals 11 over sine of 35. Now real quick before you do anything, I want you to go ahead and hit the mode button on your calculator. And within that, you're going to find that there's some options for radians or degrees. You want to make sure anytime you're working with trig ratios that you're in degrees. And right now your calculator is most likely set in radians. So if you would please just go ahead and change that by highlighting degrees, hitting enter, and then when you want to leave, just go ahead and hit second mode and that'll take care of that. All right, if you don't do that, by the way, you won't get the correct answers because your answers will be in radian mode and that won't work for what we're working with here. So if you type in 11 divided by sine of 35, you should find that x is approximately 19.18 feet. So in other words, the length of our cable for our dog run needs to be about 19.18 feet. All right, here's another example where we can use a trig ratio. It says to find the height of the lamppost to the nearest inch. So we want to know how high this lamppost is, and be careful of your precision. It does ask us to do so to the nearest inch. Well, referencing our acute angle, we have a 70 degree angle. We want to know what the opposite leg is, and in this case, we know the adjacent leg. So the hypotenuse is not being used in this particular problem. Well, if we think back to SOHCAHTOA, we are finding the opposite and we know the adjacent. So O and A, so that means we're going to use a tan function. So tan of the angle is equal to the opposite leg over the adjacent leg. So the angle we're referencing, again, can never be a right angle. It has to be one of the acute angles. So tan of 70 is equal to the opposite, which in this case is our unknown, over the adjacent, which is 40. So again, make it into a proportion and cross multiply. Our diagonal of 40 will be multiplied with tan of 70. Now, I would not put this 40 after the tan of 70, and the reason being is it might look like you're finding the tangent of 70 times 40, whereas this is really a coefficient of that tan of 70, so that is just a better way to write it. So any whole numbers or coefficient should really go in front. So 40 times the tan of 70 is equal to 1 times h, or simply h. Now in this case, I'm ready to find my simplified answer. So I can type 40 times tan of 70 into my calculator, and I find that the height is about 109.899 inches, but this asked us to find it to the nearest inch. So our height to the nearest inch is about 110 inches. So that's the height of our lamppost. All right, there's more examples today in our notes, but we're going to save those for tomorrow in class. So go ahead and finish there, and we will resume tomorrow. Have a good day.